In a roundabout way, it's possible to conditional format a chart. So let's explain what I mean by this. Here we've got product B sales during various months. What we want is somehow to clearly see where the highest month was and where the lowest months are. Now it's simple enough to do that. You've got your data, and you'll see we've created two more columns, one for the maximum. And all we do is using formula, we determine what the maximum is, and we're using an if function to see that if this is the maximum month, pull through the maximum, otherwise put a zero. And here's the minimum, same thing, it checks to see what is the minimum, and then over here it checks to see if that is a minimum and brings it through. Let's now take this chart, which currently only looks at this column, and we'll add in where the maximum is. So I'm going to drag it across. And you'll see what it's done, still a column chart, but it's shown with another color where the maximum is happening. This, however, doesn't look great, and so there must be a better way of showing this. An option would be to change this series, the maximum series, into a different chart type. So looking at this, perhaps we're happy to change it to align with markers. When I say OK, you'll see that looks a little bit better. We've now got a marker. The problem is where all the zeros are, it's actually showing us the markers, which doesn't look great. The reason these markers exist is because over here the cell says 0, 0 is a number that can be plotted. What you need to do to remove these points is to somehow convince Excel that it doesn't exist. And the way you do that is an interesting option. In your function wizard, I'm just clicked in another cell here. If I go to all my functions, you'll see there's a function available called NA. And what this does is returns the error value hash NA, value not available. What that does is forces Excel to have no value. So let's just create it. You'll see I've created a hash NA. Now let's see what happens if instead of this if function ending up in a zero, I make it equal to hash NA. You'll see the marker has disappeared. If we copy this formula all the way down, notice what has happened. Using this error message, we have told Excel to ignore all the other markers and only show the marker that has a real number on it. And this must be one of the very few uses for this particular function. So let's see how it works. That's currently the maximum number, and there it's showing there. Let's pretend we made a mistake in this month and the number is actually 260. Watch what happens on the graph. I click enter. The graph changes, but more importantly, the maximum now moves to where the maximum exists. So it is a form of conditional formatting. The graphs will move around depending on the underlying data. Just changing back to 130, and there it goes back again. Let's now do the same thing for the minimum portion. You'll see we've set up a cell to figure out what the minimum number is, and at the moment we have an if statement that if it is the minimum, it gives us the number, if not, it's zero. We now know that that needs to change so that it becomes an NA. Okay, we're just going to copy and paste it down. We can now incorporate it into the chart. Notice that we now have the minimum, the two points are identified, but there's a line in between. That is because we chose a line chart. You may want this to stay there, however you may also want only the points to be shown. So you can achieve this as follows. Click on that item, say change series chart type, and go and put on instead an XY scatter. when I click and I say OK, you'll notice that the following has happened. So you now have the points, but for whatever reason, Excel has now put a secondary axis in, and for as a result of that, the minimum, which we know should be sitting in January, is being shown in November. This is because of the secondary axis, and it's easy enough to clear. It's just important that you notice it. You can just right click on that series, go to Format Data Series, and instead of being secondary axis, which Excel has automatically put on, you can change it to primary axis. And when I say close, you'll see you've now got a graph that points out the maximum point and it points out the two minimum points. So if, for example, let's go here, and this 108 actually wasn't 108, but it was 8, when I click Enter, suddenly we'll only show the one place where the minimum exists. So that allows you to change your graph depending on some criteria here. And probably the more important part than the chart is just getting the actual spreadsheet correct. Now, what happens if you aren't happy with the markers that you have here? You can go right click on the series, say Format Data Series, and go and play with the marker options. But there is another useful way of doing it. To the right here, I've created some clip art and I've just got two arrows, a green one and a red one. To use these as my markers rather, what I can do is I click on my picture and I copy it. I go back to my chart and I click on the series. So you'll see we're on the data series at the moment. And all I do is I push Ctrl V to paste. And what you'll see is that the marker now has changed to the marker I want. And let's see if I move this to changes to 260. Let's see what happens to the chart. You'll see it moves around, but the marker I've chosen is now the marker of choice. Let's do it again. This time I'm going to take the red. I'm going to copy it. Go back here. And this time I'm going to click on this data series. You'll see they highlight it. I push Ctrl V. And you'll see I now have two arrows there. So let's change that back to 130. Let's make that 50. So you can see that your graph now will change depending on the data, and instead of having to draw arrows into the graph and then move them every time your data changes, the graph itself will move the markers around.